Hey guys, in this video I am doing a demonstration of some useful features of Windows 10 2004 20H1 update. If you find this video helpful, definitely subscribe and support me to reach 1000 subscribers. With that being said, let's dive deep into the video. New Cortana. This is one field in Windows 2004 that is significantly changed. Like other applications such as Microsoft Photos or Mail and Calendar, Cortana is now a system app. Moreover, it can be updated separately. The new Cortana comprises of a new user interface. Therefore, it permits to type queries without the need to talk over the microphone. It is useful in situations such as when we are in public using our laptops or while attending lectures, we won't be able to use the microphone methodology since people will be in close proximity or cause disturbances. Therefore, the type query method is beneficial. Additionally, don't forget that you will still be having microphone option to utilize it. The user interface highlights conversation in a methodology that we are used to, such as our day-to-day texting with our family and friends. Therefore, the conversation we have with Cortana will be visible to us like we have been texting someone. Moreover, we will be able to view the conversation back again later if required. It supports dark and light theme modes along with the text suggestions appearing below. Since Cortana is now an app, it will open up where it is used to be, but you will be able to adjust the height and width according to your needs. According to my point of view, I like it as how it is. What do you think about this improvement? Leave it in the comment section down below. I would love to hear from you guys. Even though it's a separate app now, once you close Cortana, it runs in the task manager in order to respond to Cortana command. One of the sad things to say about the new Cortana is that some of the important functions are gone, which is the functionality of being the assistant at home. Therefore, such as playing music, turning your lights on and off is gone. Now it is specifically focused on calendar events, reminder, emailing and other stuff which are related to work. Guys, honestly to say, who is controlling the home appliances from your Windows 10 machine, which makes it handy? However, Microsoft focuses on best for productivity. Updated virtual desktops. I often use virtual desktops, how about you? It is beneficial for me in many occasions, therefore I guess it's worth mentioning it in this video. Diving into the added features, now we are able to rename each individual desktops and it can be saved after reboots. This is really helpful for me guys, since compared to older version of virtual desktops, when we reboot the system, all the work will be gone and we will have to manage it back again. Enhanced settings. Microsoft is implementing actions to change from old control panel to a modern settings app. Microsoft has added cursor speed control in addition to existing setting changes. There are a lot of changes done, but I will show you guys that you will be updated with the important stuffs. Let's begin. If you have Windows Hello setup, then you will have a new option in the account section that disables your Microsoft account password. The reason that feature available is to keep your account more secure. Windows Hello is specific to each and every device we set it up. Comparing it to the previous version of Windows, if the password gets compromised, the attacker will be free to log in and access all the data. However, in the version 2004, it is tackled by this feature. Guys, unfortunately, I am unable to show you guys the implemented changes in the lock screen for the reason that my screen recording software doesn't record the lock screen. SwiftPair for Windows 10. If you don't know what this feature is, it allows you to simply pair a supported device with a single click. In the version 2004, the process has been streamlined to initial notification asking the user to connect to the device. Once the user hits connect, the notification will remain there until the pairing is complete. It's a better experience, right? What do you think? Leave it in the comment section down below. One thing to mention is that the issue with the SwiftPair now is that it supports a minimal set of Bluetooth devices. If you have a Microsoft manufactured Bluetooth device, therefore there are higher chances for it to work with the SwiftPair. You can simply find it out when you initiate the pairing process from the Bluetooth device, the notification will pop up to connect it. If not, that Bluetooth peripheral you are trying to connect doesn't support with SwiftPair. Therefore, you will have to use the old method if SwiftPair is not supported by the Bluetooth peripheral. Updated Task Manager. Talking about Task Manager, it also comprises of some new additions. The GPU temperature can be monitored in the Performance tab when clicked on the GPU. Please note that this only works on dedicated GPUs, which supports WDDM 2.4, which is Windows Display Driver Model. If the temperature is unable to be monitored, then that should be the reason. The other identifiable change is that the types of disks are separately identified if the system is using a SSD solid-state drive or hard drive or a removable storage. If you would like to know what hardware is in your PC, then this is beneficial. Notifications. The notifications include an option for the user to turn off the notification for particular apps and open app notification settings. Do you guys think this change is worth it? Leave it in the comment section down below. Optional features. You will have the ability to search through a list of optional features and sort them by name, size and installation date. Additionally, it is possible to see the installation date for every optional feature in your installed features. You also get the ability to select multiple models together and install the features. An additional thing to mention here is Microsoft has given the permission for us to delete apps such as Paint and Notepad. Text cursor. The narrator page now comprises of a new text cursor indicator that will benefit you to find the text cursor whenever required. You get the ability to select different sizes of text cursor and make it look any color you prefer with also the appearance of it. Let's have a look on this feature. Hey guys, by the way, don't forget to subscribe and support this channel. That means a lot to me. Hope to see you guys in the upcoming videos.